AMD versus Intel. In 2021, which of these CPUs should you go for? And that's a question that's been on my mind lately to the point where I'm starting to think, does this argument of CPU maker even matter anymore when things are so distorted even from 2 years ago when AMD first released Zen 2 to the wild? And that was 2019. That was a year when the Ryzen 5 3600 was released. It was kicking Intel so hard in terms of value for money. And then Intel responded with their 10th gen. And since then, the prices have gone on very different trajectories where we've seen a kind of reversal in the traditional roles of these two CPU makers. Let's take a look at the market and let's discuss.
If you've got this annoying Windows needs activation message and you want to get rid of it for cheap, then today's video sponsor SCD Keys has you covered. For as little as 14 bucks, after you use the coupon code BFTYC, you can get yourself a legit single end user Windows 10 license today. Links in the description below.
So I was looking to build a PC for someone the other day and I asked them what CPU they wanted and they said they wanted to get an i7, a 10th gen. And I said, well, have you thought about looking at say the Ryzen 7 3700X? And their response was, well, the Ryzen 7 3700X, Brian, it costs more than the i7. Can we just go with the i7? Because I'm getting the same core and thread count. And then I went and stopped and looked at the market itself. And indeed what they were saying was very true. The AMD CPUs, even the Zen 2 CPUs, that's the 3000 series CPUs, were coming in more expensive than the Intel 10th gen CPUs. And in Australia, the worst that I can see the differential between is the i5-10400F and the Ryzen 5 3600, where at most retailers, they now share pretty much a 100 Aussie dollar difference between these two CPUs. So the cost of going AMD has now been factored into the market as more of a premium than it's ever been, where typically, say for instance, when the 3600 was first released, it was coming in around a similar or even better price point than Intel's i5-9400 at the time. It also had more threads in that the i5-9400 had 6 cores, 6 threads. So the Ryzen 5 3600 at that time was a much better buy. But it seems like since then that retail pricing has gone all sorts of haywire and retailers realize that they can charge more because there's more demand there for that brand name and that logo. And this pricing doesn't just span from the fact that GPU market has gone completely wild, and as long as those cryptocurrencies are sky high in terms of especially Ethereum, I'm looking at you going over recently at like 1400 US, with those prices going to an all-time high and people mining those cryptocurrencies, there's going to be that huge demand for GPUs. So in terms of the GPU market, that's still messed up. If you want to look at what the GPUs to buy are now, I've made a video recently talking about that. I'll put the link up here. But back to the CPUs. Usually when I heard the response of, I want CPU X, I want GPU X, I usually come up with a, okay, how about we go with this instead? But this time around, I really had no counter. I just said, well, the i7 looks pretty good. The 10700F looks like a great buy. I mean, the price of this CPU is coming in at a very good point for 8 cores, 16 threads in Australia. If we adjust that to USD terms, that's a 300 USD CPU for 8 cores, 16 threads. And it comes with a cooler. That's pretty much what AMD's offering when they released their 3700X, which was one of my favorite CPUs of all time. Though if we fast forward now to 2021, AMD have since then released their Ryzen 5000 series CPUs. Now, when I look at the prices of these CPUs, they're pretty much sold out in a lot of places. But that doesn't really make any sense because the prices are a lot higher on these CPUs. So it makes me wonder what is going on with AMD and their supply of retail 5000 series CPUs. So I did a little bit more digging and I found out that 7 nanometer is in real hot demand. TSMC are pretty much booked out on their 7 nanometer production node. And so what that means is that since AMD have to fulfill all these contracts with Microsoft and Sony, for example, they've got a set quota that once that 7 nanometer is filled out, they have to fulfill all their obligations first. So basically what this means is the retail channels, that's guys like you and I wanting to buy a retail CPU, like a 5000 series, we come pretty much dead last in terms of the supply chain. So that could be reason why you're seeing the higher prices than normal on Ryzen 5000 series, as well as the low stock numbers. But then I stopped and looked at one CPU in particular in Australia. That was the 5800X. I mean, when I checked this out for 450 USD, I said to myself, if you want the best gaming CPU, it's it out of the box, right? If you don't really know how to overclock and you just want something that's gonna do a really good job, that CPU is gonna be it, but it's gonna cost a premium. But in Australia, this thing costs a premium now of 800 Aussie dollars. And that's when you break that down, it's actually a scary reality because that's pretty much $100 a core that you're paying for this CPU. And we look at the, say, the Ryzen 3 3100 or the i3-10100F, they're coming in at around $120 where I am, or $150. And so now your price per core is really out of whack. And also another thing that I'm finding in general is this trend that higher end gear is just becoming more expensive. And there's now this new echelon of pricing for the higher end GPUs and higher end CPUs. And it feels like in ways, there's this massive squeeze at the moment on the market. And I'm not talking about particular stonks, I'm talking about a squeeze at the market on the lower end, where you can't buy a lot of low end parts because a lot of them are simply becoming out of stock to the point where it's pushing people into the higher end of the market. So what I'm here to say, all in retrospect, is this year in relation to the i7 versus the Ryzen 7 or the i3 versus the Ryzen 3, is that it really doesn't matter in 2021 which CPU you get. I think what matters is the price that these CPUs are coming in at, because they're so distorted from their typical MSRPs that the arguments that a lot of us said in previous reviews over the years is not making sense anymore. I mean, I never thought Intel's 4-core 8-threaded CPU would be 119 Aussie dollars. That's the cheapest a 4-core 8-threaded CPU has ever been. Yet, not many people are talking about that value, and people are still shifting focus to a Ryzen 5 3600. So there's another $200 that you're outlaying on the table, and in a lot of cases, I feel like a lot of people coupling these with mid-range graphics cards just aren't going to be extracting that price performance out of what typically with AMD was a brand that represented amazing price performance. And so coming out of this video, I'm gonna make some recommendations for CPUs based on the price point and the stock levels that I've seen available at the moment. And coming in at number one is actually gonna be going back i3-10100F. I love this CPU, even though the i3 is not good for flipping PCs. If you're gonna flip a PC, maybe just call it a 10100F 4-core 8-thread. Just leave the i3 out of the description, because people are gonna look at it and go, i3, isn't that a terrible CPU? My friends told me i3 was terrible. Yet this i3 performs better than an i7-6700. And it's also a new CPU versus a new CPU. And you've got 3-year warranty versus something that's gonna be out of warranty now. So the value of this i3 is definitely hitting hard, just like the Ryzen 3 3100. Now the Ryzen 3 3100, I love this CPU just for the same reasons as the i3-10100F. It's AMD's answer for the budget masses, it's great price performance, and the good thing about this CPU is you can actually get it on AliExpress for $108 shipped worldwide right now, where, especially in Australia and a lot of other places, this CPU is actually sold out. Though as we're stepping things up, my choices of CPUs is actually gonna change a little bit based on the current market conditions, and that is the 10400F, the i5, 6 cores, 12 threads, especially if you're in Australia, $220, this CPU is a no-brainer. Now, the Ryzen 5 3600 costing now $100 more, where I've seen this CPU go for, say, $250 in the past, it's definitely being priced at a premium versus the i5. So I'd go for the i5 if it's a lot cheaper, which it is at its current price point. And then we step things up to the i7-10700F. Really good buy at the moment for $439. Same argument as the 10400F. It's a really cheap 8-core 16 thread. Then the last pick in the bunch is, well, actually two picks from AMD. And that is if you want the best gaming performance, you've got the 5800X there. But as we said before, that cost per core is sky high at the moment. And then if you want a workstation CPU, they've got the 5900X, which I've tested in the past. And I'll put a link to the review of the 5900X. Really good CPU that's definitely gonna give you a solid workstation experience. And so moving forward, we see here with the market, it's constantly changing. It's constantly, I wouldn't say evolving, I was gonna say evolving, but it seems like in ways it's maybe devolving. But what we've seen with PC gaming in general is there's been massive growth in this industry. It doesn't matter which article you look at, you can see the general trend with PC gaming is that it keeps on growing, especially due to the COVID situation going on worldwide. People are staying indoors more, and so they're going to need more gaming components. It just sucks that the cryptocurrency boom has put strain on the GPU prices, which when we look at the prices of CPUs, RAM, SSDs, motherboards, everything else in the pipeline is actually coming in with a pretty good price point. I think except high-end power supplies there, they also, when it comes to cryptocurrency booms, they also get pretty much sold out as well. But when all's said and done, when it comes down to picking out PC parts, I always look at one thing, and that's the raw value for money that you're getting versus the brand and fancy labels that are slapped on a box. And so what I'm seeing with the market this year and the Intel versus AMD argument, traditionally, all those arguments are now switched upside down, where it feels like Intel's gone from being the performance king to now being the value king, and then AMD was the value king, now they're turning into the performance king. And if that's what I'm seeing, and then let me know in the comments if you feel different about this whole situation, as I love reading your thoughts and opinions as always. But if you've got your favorite CPU as well, be sure to drop that in the comment section below and we'll get discussing. Because as I said in the intro, when I checked out the prices for a client, my recommendations were really left like turned upside down. I'm like, what's going on with this market? Anyhow, we got the question of the day here, which comes from Daniel Bryan, and they ask, anyone got an idea if the shop 9114400013 store on AliExpress is real? I was going to buy a GTX 1050 Ti or 1060 as they are so cheap, but I'm hesitant. And I think we checked out this exact store on a live stream when I was looking at prices of CPUs, and it just looked too good to be true. So someone said that they bought something and they also got a refund because the seller never sent them a tracking number or shipped it out. So do be careful of that store. I mean, I spoke about it on the live stream where I said, be very careful when someone's selling something that comes significantly under the next competitor. Usually when you've got a product and you know it's going to sell well, you don't price it at a point that's significantly undercutting the competition, because it'll just sell. You'll be out of stock in a day. What will happen is though, if you price it say a dollar cheaper, you'll then start gathering steady sales and you'll be able to sell it. Or even if you want to hot sell it $5 cheaper. Because what they were charging on some of their prices was like $20 cheaper or $30 cheaper. I'm just like, that's too good to be true. And as I've said in the past, I'll say this actually, it's probably gonna be more of a regular saying here on the channel, because the amount of scams that are going on is going up and up and up. And that is, when something's too good to be true, it usually is. And if you guys have stayed this far and you're enjoying that Tech Yes content, then be sure to hit that sub button, ring that bell, and I'll catch you in the next one. Peace out for now. Bye.